There's this push to find biological materials that have very useful properties for more man-made structures. Can we take what nature gave us and now build something in a lab setting? My name is John Tomko. I'm a upcoming fourth year graduate student in Patrick Hopkins' lab here at the University of Virginia, where we focus on nanoscale heat transfer. Our unique discovery was these crazy thermal properties of what's called squid ring teeth protein. These proteins are found on the tentacles of squid. They have these teeth-like structures, they're almost like fingernails in a way. And they have this crazy unique property where they're actually self-healing.
So if a squid chips a nail, that's what they use to claw their prey and then, you know, shove it into their beak and into their mouth. So if they chip a nail, they lose the ability to eat. So it's a survival mechanism where that protein regenerates with a little bit of energy. We started working with a group out of Penn State who's making these squid ring teeth proteins. And that's when I realized you might be sitting on this really remarkable idea that you can modulate the thermal properties just by taking the protein and getting it wet.
We can immediately think of applications of this. So the first is active wear. You can think of most athletic clothing, for example, or the shirt I'm wearing now. Again, constant thermal conductivity. But the nice thing about squid would be it has a low thermal conductivity, which means it's very insulating when it's dry. And then when it hydrates, you can imagine I start sweating, I'm heating up.
As your body gets hot, it can passively cool your body with no energy. Think about like a personal air conditioner that doesn't require you to plug anything in. Squid ring teeth protein, the thermal properties, or the temperature, can change by almost a factor of 5 just by getting it wet. That order of magnitude of thermal property change has never been realized before in any other material. We're also finding it could be remarkable for energy storage. I mean, this could revolutionize like a thermal battery. If we understand that fundamental aspect of things, then we can work on any application we want because we can find unique solutions to a wide variety of technologies.
Patagonia, the clothing company, every year has a call for these CAPES competitions for MBA students to submit proposals, essentially, to solve some critical problem that the company is facing. So we wrote an entire proposal around new materials, but particularly these squid proteins, and saying, these are green materials, they have these very unique properties, and they're not that hard to manufacture. So this collaboration actually ended up in us winning this Patagonia case competition.
I really do think the best part of this job and the best part of what I do is the interaction with the students, because they're the ones that are actually generating the new knowledge. They are coming up and reporting brand new things, and I get to talk to them about it, and it's so fun.
We have so many researchers that are just at the peak level of creativity. They're publishing in really high impact papers, and that's coming from these very novel ideas.
We found this material by looking at a totally different field and looking at how this protein has evolved over millennia in the ocean in squid.
And nobody's done that until now. And the door that opens is just huge. I do believe this finding is very important, if not only for applications, but also for pushing fundamental science and development of new materials.